Playing a beautiful piece of music is maybe the best feeling in the world.
Meet Sarah Jeffrey, wife, mother, Toronto Symphony Orchestra musician.
There are a lot of people who love to do what they do by themselves. Not me. I want to be amongst 100 people. I want to be sharing it with everybody else. It's all about the music making within the large group for me.
Sarah's talent matches her enthusiasm. In addition to being a celebrated recitalist and chamber musician, Sarah is also the TSO's principal oboe.
Well, my goal musically is to stay in the moment. It's to stay at the top of my game and to just try and play the most beautifully I can play every single time I pick up the oboe. When I play the oboe, I want to be a singer. To me, it's a voice and it's a vocal line rather than an instrument in my hands where I'm producing a sound. It's as though I'm singing but not using words. And so when the air comes out of me and into my instrument, the way that my reed vibrates, the way my vibrato works, the way the colors change with the phrase, it's all because I'm trying to sing through my oboe.
Sarah played other instruments, but she never really felt a connection to them.
My father's a French horn player, and my mother's a pianist, and I started playing piano and violin at age 3, both of them. So that's how I began. I played the violin for about 10 years, and in that 10 years, I asked repeatedly to quit. My father finally, when I was 13, said, "You can now quit the violin, but only if you pick up the oboe, because you've learned a tremendous amount of skill in music on the violin, and you can play the oboe." And I said, "Whatever. Whatever instrument you want me to play, I'll play." So I picked up the oboe and I immediately fell in love with it. The talent just kind of, it just flowed out. It really was my voice, and as soon as I found it, I couldn't stop. The oboe sound is, to me, it's perfect. It's because it has this wonderful soprano vocal lightness to it, and yet there's this piercing anguish. It seems to me that it's the only instrument that really represents true, true, true happiness, elation, but also the sorrow that is always in the movies and in everything else is always expressed by the oboe. It's incredible. It just gets right into you. And when I'm playing, that's what I want to do. I try to tap into every single one of the 2,200 people that I'm playing for. In order to play the oboe, you need to make reeds. That's the thing that nobody told me when I was handed an oboe, that you needed to make reeds.
Reeds are made out of strips of cane. When blown over, they vibrate to produce a sound. Oboes are classified as double reed instruments because they use two slightly separated strips.
In order to make a very, very good reed, you need to be very particular about the process and very careful in when you're choosing the different parts of what will become your reed. Here we have a piece of cane. It's now going to go through the gouging machine, and the gouging machine is the most important step, really, of the reed making. It's what determines your sound, your tone, your pitch, which are the most important parts of making reeds. So different reeds will make different sounds. So you might have the reed that's perfect for Brahms, but it won't do Mozart very well because you need the lightness in Mozart. So people tend to go a little crazy because you're so focused and you're so determined, and you have to have the perfect reed to sound like the perfect oboe player. And you can spend a lot of time obsessing. Okay, we're just trying to get enough cane off so it vibrates. it's a little bit noisy for what I like, so I'm going to keep scraping, see if I can balance it out. Over the course of the week, with a few rehearsals and concerts, I will go through probably four of them, use them out so I can't use them the next week, and then I'll start the process again over for the next week. The time to make a read in a day probably is 2 to 3 hours a day. So it adds up. It's my whole day. My husband just said last night, if it wasn't for these reads, we could, you know.
But Gabriel Radford does understand Sarah's drive. He is a horn player with the orchestra, making music this family's way of life.
We're extremely fortunate people. We grew up together in Toronto. We went to the same high school, and we went to the Toronto Symphony Youth Orchestra together. And by a miracle, we landed jobs in the same orchestra together. So music is happening around us all the time. Now we have two little children. We have a 3-year-old daughter named Evelyn and a 1-year-old named Aiden. I would love them to just be able to do whatever they want to do, but of course have some musical training because their parents do it 3 times a week. Music has taught me everything. I've learned to be kind to myself. alongside of being extremely dedicated and focused and working as hard as I can towards a goal. I've learned to play well with others. I've learned to share my talents and my gifts with everyone else the way I expect them to share their talents and their gifts with me. I've learned to always seek happiness and to spread happiness around the world. And I think I've learned all of this through music.